I've never felt like I was gonna throw up before after a workout. I definitely feel that a wee bit, so.
Feel the burn, baby, feel the burn.
I don't know how to cook. I haven't worked out since high school.
Are you regretting this?
This sh- is gonna be hard. Garrett has no idea what he's in for.
What happened, Garrett?
I just threw up a lot.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to my YouTube channel and to my series, Extreme Body Makeover. As you guys know, over the past year, I've taken on a lot of extreme challenges, whether it's training like a superhero or a supermodel. And along the way, a lot of my friends and people close to me have asked about taking on their own fitness journeys. So I decided it's time to give back. On the first episode of the series, I gave an extreme body makeover to my dear friend, Olivia Marie. And if you guys missed that episode, it was amazing. Be sure to check it out in the links below. Olivia worked so hard and I am so proud of her results. So today I'm really excited to get started on my second extreme body makeover with someone else who is very close to me, my boyfriend, Garrett. Fitness has been something that I've never really been able to share with a partner. Usually it's something that I do by myself outside of the relationship. Garrett is the first person I've ever been with that has wanted this to be different.
It's been about 7 to 10 years.
7 to 10 years.
Since I've legitimately worked out. I realize at the age of 25, I should probably be at the prime of my physical fitness, and I'm not. This is less about looking good, even though that's a great bonus. It's more about,
you look good.
Thanks. It's more about just being fit and living a healthier lifestyle.
This is gonna be really different from my makeover with Olivia. Garrett and I live together, we work together, and now we're going to be working out together. See, you don't think this is gonna negatively affect our relationship?
Nah.
I don't really think he understands what he's getting himself in for. Taking on an extreme body makeover is more than just working out for an hour every day. It's a complete lifestyle change.
It's gonna be challenging, but I need to do this.
For me?
No, for myself. I don't feel healthy. I feel like I shovel a bunch of bad food into my mouth.
Bagel bites.
Little bagel bites.
Now you can give them pizza whenever they want.
Pop-Tarts. Frozen pizza.
The sauce commands your attention. The cheese begs you to savor every bite.
I'm going to treat you like I would treat anyone else. I will support you, and I will also kick your ass.
Deal. Challenge accepted.
Wrong show.
But go check out that series.
For the next 7 weeks, I'll be giving Garrett an extreme body makeover. And at the end of the training period, Garrett will be doing his very own celebrity style photo shoot. And hopefully I'm not single by the end of this.
I have snuck away to KFC. It's my last meal before I start this health and fitness journey.
I haven't worked out since high school. I will do hikes here and there, but honestly, as of late, I have done close to nothing in terms of fitness. It's been a lot of working and a lot less working out. I'm excited to hopefully get that routine back into my life. 80% of the content we make is me watching Michelle kill herself in a gym. I'm a little terrified and nervous to do that myself. Michelle has done UFC fighting. I'm not gonna do that. Michelle has run a marathon.
Michelle, you gotta pick it up!
I can't give up!
I don't think I'm gonna do that. All of those things terrify me, but also excite me and motivate me. This is something I've been wanting to do for a long time, and I'm excited that it's finally time for that to happen.
Garrett, I'm really excited to introduce you to Jesus and Moses. Also known as Film Fit. They completely transformed my life last year when we did the Star Wars video. I always refer to Film Fit as the people who are the kindest, most understanding, and like with you every step of the way.
5 or 6 years ago, you were working out. What were you doing?
I don't know what I was doing. I don't know what I am doing in terms of working out. I would go to the gym a couple times a week doing what I assumed was working out, but like, again, I had zero guidance. I would love to apply actual routine and a systematic approach.
Let's talk a little bit about goals then. You want to look like Chris Pratt.
Yeah, that sounds great. Other than how Chris Pratt is just the most charming person in existence.
You want to consult here or
in my bungalow.
It was really cool to see his physical transformation on screen over the years of his career, going from what he looked like in Parks and Rec to what he looks like now in all the big superhero Marvel movies. Yes, it would be nice to look like that, but for me, this journey is more about a mental thing and getting into the headspace of routine and discipline. Honestly, I just want to be in shape and feel good about being healthy and know that I'm not gonna die soon.
Okay. I know that was a concern.
Well, not that.
Christ.
My diet is horrible. I just eat whatever I want, when I want. My worry is less about working out and more about food and nutrition. I've never learned how to cook from my parents. I'm really bad at it, so I'm hoping Michelle and Nick and Brandon can somehow whip my ass into shape and teach me how to cook properly. It would be cool to just cook a meal, not just for myself, but for somebody else. I think that would be really special. Alcohol. What are the rules on that? I drink normally for social reasons. I play Dungeons and Dragons a lot, and when I do that, I end up drinking with my friends. So that's something I'm not gonna be able to do for a while.
Because our time with him is fairly limited, we need to make sure he's performing at his absolute best. So although he enjoys a cocktail from time to time, there really is gonna be no room for that.
I have no idea how much I weigh, so I guess it's a good time to find out. My goal was to go from 18% body fat to 12% body fat. And I kept thinking to myself, how is this going to get to 12%? How much crying will go into getting to a 12%?
From the training or nutrition?
Both.
Training?
Fair amount.
Okay, great.
So when Chris Pratt made his transformation from Andy Dwyer to Star-Lord, he lost a lot of body fat, and that's gonna be our main goal here, build some muscle and burn that body fat. Another aspect of our workouts that we're focusing on is foot positioning. From my perspective, Garrett has a little bit of a waddle that we're gonna try and correct. If you think of your foot position as your foundation, we needed to build a strong foundation in order to reap the benefits of the rest of our exercises.
So a lot of people think that if you get a celebrity trainer and nutritionist, everything is super easy and straightforward, but that's only a portion of the story, and there's still a ton of work you have to do on your own, like meal prep and preparing for workouts, scheduling your day appropriately, taking on the fatigue of the new lifestyle, and this is something I don't think Garrett really anticipated.
It's 6 a.m. We have a group workout this morning. Gotta go wake up Garrett. Let's see how this goes. Garrett, are you so excited to work out?
No, we go tomorrow.
We are going tomorrow.
All right, guys, welcome to my home away from home. We're gonna do a 5-minute run here, get the blood pumping. All right, guys, a couple minutes in, I hear a lot of stomping. Light on those feet, get in that rhythm. We're gonna do some dynamic stretches here.
Always warm up, can't just do a long stretch, you gotta do a dynamic stretch like this.
The first one's gonna be a knee tuck, 5 reps each leg. All right, everybody gets a mat, regular old sit-up. First one's always the hardest. Next one hand stays behind the head, the other arm is out straight. Feel the burn, baby, feel the burn.
Really fun.
Are you regretting this?
No, it was just fun to hear after all that. Oh, warm up is complete. Cool.
Form is gonna be an issue that we definitely need to approach early and often. I love how Garrett worked through when he knew he was struggling. He was able to finish the set, finish the workout. Garrett absolutely reminds me of an early Chris Pratt. He's got so much potential that we can totally unlock.
I'm pretty f***ed up right now. I'm dizzy and I've never felt like I was gonna throw up before after a workout. And I definitely feel that a wee bit, so.
What happened, Garrett?
I just threw up a lot, but now I feel great.
This is why I've never brought people to work out with me. I'm just so scared they're gonna get to hate it and hate me.
I had a very rough week one for many reasons, food and working out. Basically, the whole thing was a disaster.
One thing that Garrett's really gonna need to ramp up is his water intake. He's not drinking enough water. Most of my clients in the beginning aren't. A lot of people think that 8 8-ounce glasses a day is good. That's really just a generalization. A really easy way to kind of determine how much water you should take is take your weight, divide it by 2, and that's how many ounces per day you should be taking in.
I just got an email from Brandon, which outlines my diet. It's very specific.
down to exactly how many like grams of something that I need to eat. So I guess I'm gonna be measuring and weighing a lot of my food. Oh, and there's like specific times that I need to eat too, so that's cool. That's gonna be real easy to pull off. It's gonna be boring. It's fine for now. I know going forward it's going to be miserable. Because I like eating all this stuff. I just don't like eating nothing else but this. I want a nice Reuben sandwich every once in a while.
Garrett's not happy.
I'm really happy. I'm not upset.
We're on set today.
I walked by Crafty and I instinctually grabbed the Twix, and as I was walking away, I throw it back. He's like, can't have that. I can have these almonds though. Sure love almonds.
So a unique but exciting challenge for this video was that Garrett did not know how to cook.
Good morning, Garrett. How's breakfast going?
Well, I've made none of it so far. Are these your eggs?
Those are mine. You're gonna make yours.
Sick.
The last thing that I wanted to do was scare somebody out of their own health and fitness challenge. So I compensated for that in the first week by being extremely and probably a bit overly supportive. I would drive both of us to the gym. I scheduled all of the workouts. I made sure everything was perfect in Google Calendar. I bought all of the groceries. I cooked all of the meals for both myself and Garrett. And then I realized that if this was going to be a sustainable life change for Garrett, he was gonna have to learn how to do everything himself. And that was a type of letting go that was really difficult for me because I didn't want him to crash and burn and really hate the experience.
Garrett, what happened?
I'm making my protein shake, or trying to make my protein
shake. Why are you doing it in a mug with the opposite side of the knife?
This seems complicated.
It's actually not. This is the simplest meal.
So I last minute have to go to New York City for 24 hours. I am concerned about Garrett. This first week it's really crucial to have support, and I feel terrible that I have to leave. I hope that he's okay. I heard that he didn't eat today before working out again.
I didn't throw up, but I feel like I'm gonna throw up again. This morning I shoveled all of my meal into my mouth 10 minutes before I went to the gym. The whole time I feel like I wanna puke, and that's my fault, and I need to make sure that I eat at a proper time. And man, is it f***ing hard. I'm gonna get better at it, but when you're not eating correctly, working out is nearly impossible.
Your food is fuel. So if you're not providing the proper fuel for your quote unquote gas tank, you're not going to be able to reap all of the benefits that you could from your workouts. If you're eating microwave meals and fast food, you're getting calories, but you're not getting the correct balances of carbs to fats to proteins. So that's where proper nutrition planning really comes into play.
The greater portion of what you do in the kitchen is going to affect your results. So you can work out all day long, but if your nutrition isn't on par, then you're not gonna get the results you want.
Week one scared me a little bit. I thought week one was going to be me saying, hey, Michelle, how can I do this better? How should I do this? And Michelle decided to selfishly go to New York without me.
Are you kidding me, Garrett?
Her leaving to New York taught me that I could not rely on her for that. By the end of week one, I realized that I need to get my shit together, because if every week is going to be like week one, I'm not going to make it to the end.
Lit Saturday night.
Welcome to Garrett and Michelle's MasterChef kitchen.
I'm showing Garrett meal prep so that you don't have to cook as much.
We're gonna do three types of chicken here. Balsamic, and we're gonna do like lemon.
Cilantro lemon chicken.
The protein that we chose was chicken. That way he's just focusing on one thing to cook. Since he's kind of a newbie to cooking, chicken's kind of hard to mess up. It's gonna help him with the recovery process from his workouts. It's gonna help him build muscle. As far as seasoning it, there's a lot of really great seasons that you can do that are really easy. Garlic's always good. Rosemary's nice. Even good old-fashioned salt and pepper goes a long way as far as flavor. If you can enjoy it with just a subtle flavor, it's really not hard to do.
Starting with week two, I made sure that I knew how to cook all my meals. I made sure that I felt confident and comfortable going to the gym and doing my workout routine.
I'm so proud of Garrett. He just made his egg whites.
Are these supposed to taste good? Why am I eating the not delicious part of the egg?
Okay, so the healthy part of the egg is the egg white.
This part of the egg is less tasty than the other part of the egg.
I'm very proud of you for eating at all today, because that has been a struggle for you.
Despite all of the challenges that Garrett went through learning how to cook cook and organize his life in that way, it eventually became this incredible environment where we could finally support each other.
Okay, I'm gonna try the meal you made for me. Oh my God! The chicken's cooked, that's your great son. I love the crisping on the outside. Visually, it looks very nice. Really good for it.
Yay!
I'm so proud of you because, like, when we started, you didn't even know how to know if a chicken was cooked. Now you made this, and this is amazing.
I've got my powder and my orange juice, and I'm about to go to training. The exercises have been getting easier to do because I'm getting used to the movements and the form, so I think I'm getting a lot better with that.
I like to alternate my exercises on an every other week basis with my clients. And basically the reason behind that is, if you were to do the same exercise every workout or every week, eventually you'll reach a limit of what you're able to do under those circumstances. So by alternating different workouts, we're able to not only extend the amount of time where we're able to see progress, but we're able to see more progress over that period of time. If you guys are interested in doing one of Garrett's workouts, I've provided a link in the description below.
It's getting difficult to manage all of this and still make time to eat and to work out. We've been doing a lot of traveling. It's been a lot, but thankfully I have Michelle here helping me. Honestly, I don't know how I would be doing this without her guidance. So thank you, Michelle.
The first couple of weeks, the workouts were one-on-one, just Nick and I. I started getting into a rhythm and started building momentum with this new lifestyle change. That was great, but it got even better when, for the second half of the challenge, every one-on-one workout became Michelle and I working out together with Nick. That really elevated this experience for me. Going to the gym with somebody as motivated and committed as Michelle was very inspiring to me. There was this weird duality happening of me being embarrassed, like, why can't I keep up with Michelle? But then I would immediately be like, oh no, I need to keep up, so I'm gonna work harder.
One thing that happened in this challenge for me that I wasn't really anticipating was that in a relationship, there is a special bond that forms when you see each other struggle in a workout. There's a sense of camaraderie that starts with the workout, but then translates to all other aspects of your life together.
Honestly, I'm excited to get to do this with a partner and somebody else who truly genuinely cares about this experience, not just for herself, but for other people as well.
I'll be honest, I've always dreamed of having a partner who wakes up early with me, cooks breakfast with me, and goes to the gym with me. And to have that now is so fucking awesome. I can't help but feel like the luckiest girl in the world. Garrett, what's going on?
My legs are cramping really bad. I feel terrible.
But do you love me?
My calves are very sore and I can't really walk this funny.
All right, we're gonna take care of that using the handy dandy foam roller. You ready for this?
No.
Do you feel like getting the knots out?
No. I feel like a piece of pasta.
See, it's so much looser now. Do you feel that? Isn't that better? All right, whatever.
Throughout the challenge, people would throw me compliments about a change in my body.
Jawline's coming out and it's not f***ing around.
And I'm gonna be honest, I didn't actually believe them. I thought they were petty comments to make me feel better because they knew I was going through the challenge. I didn't notice a change in my body that much.
Similar to Olivia, Garrett expressed to me that he didn't feel like he was seeing any physical transformation in his body. I saw it for sure. You could definitely see a difference in his neck, in his back, his jawline. He was definitely getting results. I know this show is called Extreme Body Makeover, which I think to a lot of people implies a massive physical change. But for me, what Extreme Body Makeover means is a body makeover that goes from the inside out. Becoming a person who thinks more consciously about what they put into their body and how they live their day-to-day life.
What's really important is for people to know their numbers. So often people will get into these diets, which might yield short-term results, but they're not sustainable. Don't just get your weight on the scale. If you can get a body fat test, you can really go to literally any gym and ask a trainer to do a skin fold test. So if you have your weight and your body fat, then you can track your progress better. If my weight went up, why did it go up? Did it go up because I gained fat? They go because they gain muscle. If you know your body fat, then you know what's happening. Also, knowing your total daily energy expenditure numbers. How many calories am I burning in one day? And if you know that, then you can add or subtract based on your goal. There's a lot of different resources, but one that I use to give people just general advice if they're not looking for a detailed program is what's called TDEEcalculator.net. And it's just a terrific resource for punching in your numbers. And the program and software just kind of helps you get an idea of how many calories you need to get to your goal. But then it also tells you how many proteins, carbs, and fats you need based on your goal. It's not going to be as precise as the program I'm putting Garrett on, but it's a good start.
Another day, another group workout. Gary, how do you feel?
It's still really f***ing hard.
Livia.
Just call him Gary.
I went from hating the group cardio workouts to loving them because they were pushing me to do better.
I love working out with my friends.
Yeah. It's always better to suffer together than alone.
Garrett, what you doing?
I'm deceased.
Hello.
We just finished a training session, and I am finally starting to feel a little bit like Chris Pratt.
Our training week 7 will be by far the hardest that it's been to this point. All of our training up until this point has prepared us for what we're gonna do this week. We're gonna have some of our heaviest weights. We're gonna have our highest intensity workouts. This is gonna be hard.
Today is the last workout for the photo shoot. I'm a little bit concerned about G today.
I need water.
Gary kicked my ass today.
Today was weird. We did an exercise where we were working the same arm for like 20 minutes, and I definitely felt like that episode of Rick and Morty when Morty has the one giant arm.
Booyah! You pal! Who else wants some?
I'll be sucking in my gut on this one. I hope that's cool.
I knew my face got a little thinner, but other than that, I really didn't see any aesthetic change in myself, and that started to worry me. I started getting a little discouraged, thinking that all of this time, money, and energy was all going to nothing, and I felt like I was letting Michelle down in a way.
It's your final day, final weigh-in.
Yep.
Are you ready to hear the results?
Yeah, I guess so. We'll see.
You've been really nervous about this because he doesn't think he looks any different.
I think I look different. I just don't think it's as drastic as I hope it would be, but yeah. We'll see.
We talked about 12% being your goal for body fat. Your weight now is 182.6. So you've lost, from a weight perspective, 8.4 pounds. Lost weight, great, but that doesn't really say much about what's really happened. How much muscle have you gained? How much fat have you lost? That's where it really matters. And so your body fat, 9.9.
Damn, okay.
Ah! Cool. Crazy.
I didn't think I'd go under 10, so that's crazy.
Can you be that's like cool. Happy about
it? I am. Yeah.
That's sensational. Your goal was 12% and you blew that out of the water. In terms of fat loss in pounds, you've lost 15 and a half pounds of fat.
That's okay, two babies came off of you.
Now, muscle mass, we wanted to gain some, right? We didn't set a goal there. We just said, okay, let's lose the body fat and then hopefully gain some strength and change the physique a little bit. You gained 7.05 pounds of muscle.
Okay, cool.
Which that's is, a baby. That's, then which, you have yeah, a baby of
so
muscle
remove
back,
two babies,
on.
Yeah. One back on.
Yeah.
That's another baby.
I want you to see it. This is you 7 weeks ago, and this is you today. If you don't see a difference,
no, I do.
Just take that in.
I am.
And think about
it's a lot of the
think
face
about
too.
The time. It's not a lot of time.
Oh my God, I got you.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. That's that nuts. It shows the most there.
Look yeah. at your back!
Yeah, yeah. Look at the waist.
That's crazy.
And obvious, yeah, I told you.
Yeah, no,
these are all things
yeah.
I told you.
Yeah, but I can't see these things from my perspective, so.
This is why we tell our clients to take before and after pictures. Mm-hmm. You gotta put it into perspective.
Yeah, look at the angle of your foot here.
My feet throughout this have gotten better. It's just lifting, doing all the weight training with the correct.
Constantly correcting.
You're not waddling anymore.
It's not duck foot.
I've never seen change in my body before, no matter what I did. So it was really cool to have this experience.
I'm so happy. I'm so proud of you. You threw up.
After the first day.
You were back and you locked it in. You figured it out. And that's the hardest part.
Look at you. I can tell you're happy. You got the little G smile. He has a little G smile.
Guess that means I'm happy.
The photo shoot was such a special day. First of all, because Garrett loves wearing suits and dressing up. Secondly, because I felt for the first time I saw this new confidence within him emerge. On my channel, Garrett, 99% of the time, is behind the camera, and to see him in front of the camera and fully own it was something I'd never seen before. And you can see it in the photos. He looks hot. I love him. It was cool to see you do something that intimidated you before. You've always been such a hard worker, but there's like a new energy about it. It was kind of crazy because you wanted to jump into this right after we moved in together, and there were a lot of big life changes happening.
Just do it all at once.
And I'm really glad we did, because I feel like it kind of set the tone for like our relationship now, which is new and exciting. And I am thankful for like everything that we went through.
Getting to experience this side of your life firsthand gave me an immense perspective on things. It made me not just respect you and your lifestyle more, but it showed me how important some of those things are and why they need to be important to me too.
I love you a lot.
I love you too.
If you enjoyed this video, and if you're really proud of Garrett like I am, please give it a thumbs up. Comment below with the next person I should take on an extreme body makeover. And as always, subscribe so we can keep on going on more adventures together. Have a great day.